Today we're going to talk about the controller fan for the MKS S-Gen L version 1.0. Now, as you may have realized already, we only have one signal pin that we can use to control a fan, and we normally use that for our fan controller for our extruder. Or our hot end, as some people would like to refer to it as well. So in this case, what we're trying to do is actually create a controlled cooling of our steppers. So I'm going to show you how to do that without using these set of pins. And this is only designed for the case where someone may be using only one extruder. If you use a second extruder, you're going to have to navigate to other pins to do this. So I'm going to avoid that subject for the moment because it's a little bit more in depth and this is quite simple to follow. But you may be able to figure it out based on what I'm doing here with something such as a fan extender. But in this case, I have to let you know before we begin that I purchased all of the equipment in this video with my own money. And no one's paying me or sponsoring me to do this tutorial, but I will be placing Amazon affiliate links in the description for your convenience. So, first thing that we want to start with is the MKS S-Gen L pin interface diagram. As you can see on here, we have the actual pin numbers for each one of our extruders, and as we're not using this one, we're going to use our second extruder, which is hot end 1. And as you can see, the pin number is P2.6. So we need to keep that in mind when we're going to be hooking up the second fan. So to hook up the fan now, what we need to do is we need to connect our red and black ports over here. Now, if you haven't noticed, I did put ferrules on these. They're not well done, but it will increase the safety of your configuration for both your hot ends and your heat bed. So the first thing that I want to do is I actually want to loosen the bolts over here in the block in order to connect these. And then of course you can see over here that it's negative on the black and the red is marked on the actual top for your convenience to understand what I'm doing. So I'm going to then slide these in to the block below. Now this may take a little bit of wiggling because I've not used this block before, so I may have to loosen it just a bit. And let's slide those in. So now that they're both secure, I'm going to tighten this block down to make sure they don't move around. And so these are good and secure. So the next thing we need to do in order to load the firmware is we need to connect the USB serial for the big end. And then the small end we're going to need to connect to our computer, so you may hear a beep. So the first thing that I do want to show you is that this is the latest release of 2.0.x, which I downloaded right here. And then I, inside my downloads folder, actually extracted it. So it's right here. Now, one of the things that I need to point out is that currently this is the USB drive connection to the MKS S-Gen L version 1.0. And as you can see, it's firmware.cur in all capital letters. That means that a firmware was loaded back in September on this board. So we're going to go over to VS Code with platform IO loaded. And as you can see, it says the core version, and then it says its home version. That's what I'm currently working off of. So I'm going to click on the Explorer over here, Then I'm going to go to open folder. And I'm already mapped to the extracted folder for Marlin, but I need to go one level deeper. Then I need to select the folder in question. And this is going to load our environment so that we can work with it. So now I'm going to click on the Marlin folder, then the source folder, then the core folder, then boards.h. Inside here, I'm going to do a search on MKS underscore SGen underscore L. And that'll bring us to our board, which is the LPC 1768. So I'm going to copy this. Then I'm going to close out of boards.h. I'm going to collapse the folder for core source. And I'm going to go to configuration.h. Inside configuration.h, I'm going to search on motherboard. And I'm going to highlight the board for the ramps and paste our board over it. Next, I'm going to scroll up and I'm going to change the serial port from 0 to negative 1. And because this is a fresh download of the Marlin firmware, I need to change our steppers. So I'm going to search on the A4988. And that'll bring us to our X and Y steppers. So I'm going to remove the comment for our X stepper and our Y stepper. And then because these are TMC2208s, I'm going to copy that right there and paste it here and do the same for this one. Now I've done a previous video on how to configure this that I'll include in the link in the upper right hand corner if you so desire to understand how to do that. But for now I'm keeping it short. So what I need to do right now is go to the configuration underscore adv.h, which is for advanced, and search on controller. And this brings us to controller fan. So down here, it's not enabled because the comment is located in the front. So we need to remove the comment. And now it's asking us to define an actual pin. So we need to remove the comment there as well. So in order to define the pin, we need to know what it says in the pins file for the MKS SGenL. So we're going to go to the source folder. Then we're going to go to pins. Then we're going to locate the LPC 1768. And inside here, we should find our board, which is the MKS SGenL.h. And then we're going to scroll down through this file, and we're going to look for that particular pin that I was talking about a few moments ago. And that was our second stepper. So we're going to find our extruder in here someplace. Now, obviously, I'm not seeing it right away, but it's P2. And it's probably our second heater. Or in this case, they're calling it a fan. So we're going to have to go back and check the diagram real quick. So over in here, it says P2.6. as our second fan, when P2.4 is our first fan. So if we go back here and look, it says fan 1. What they mean is your second fan. So what we're going to need to do is actually take this, copy it, then we're going to go back over to our, pardon me for a second, we're going to reduce this down. We're going to go to our advanced configuration, and we're actually going to paste our pin over the negative 1. So that is our actual pin that we'll be using that'll automatically turn on our fan. So I'm going to change this to about 200 for our fan speed. And then for the idle time after motors stop moving, I'm going to reduce this down to 5 seconds just so you can see what's occurring rather than 60 seconds. So now that we have that configured, we need to set up our platform.io.ini environment. And as you can see, right now it's set to the Mega 2560. So we need to change that to LPC1768 for our chipset. And then in order to compile this, we can actually send it directly to our board with upload. So this will do a actual build or compile and then upload to our board. So let's click that and see what happens. So this may take a moment. I did a previous tutorial in another board framework, so it may fail. If it does fail, you can always click on this little garbage can to clean your build. We'll let that run for a moment, and then I'll show you what we can actually find out from this. Now it says that it's uploading to the board right here, which is rather quick for this build. So let's give it a moment and see what happens. So it looks like the actual build was successful because it says successful, and it was about just under 2 minutes. So let's check the actual drive for the USB. As we can see, it uploaded the firmware.bin in lower cases to the USB drive for the MKS SGen L. So in order to load this, what we need to do is power cycle the USB by removing it. So I'm going to remove the USB for a moment. Then I'm going to reconnect it. And what's occurring now is it's loading the firmware on your MKS SGen L. And as you can see, the time has changed, and it's now in all capital letters. This means that the actual firmware load was successful from this standpoint. So next, we're going to test it. So to test this, we actually need board power in order to do that, meaning from a power supply. So currently, it's disconnected, as you can see. So I'm going to remove the USB power for a moment, and I'm going to connect our two connectors. And as you can see, I marked red and black on top so you can see how to connect it. And I also placed ferrules on both of these connectors in order to protect the wiring so it doesn't accidentally have a frayed wire that goes to the other side. I'll include this in the link in the description for your convenience and where you can find it to actually do this yourself. So I'm going to place these in the block. I'm then going to screw it down. This makes sure that they won't move around afterwards, so you want to give it a nice little bit of torque. So that's nice and secure. Now, whenever using the actual direct power for the board, you want to keep in mind not to touch the actual hardware, because one, it could harm you, and two, you can harm your equipment. So I'm going to first connect this. Then I'm going to take the actual direct power, which in this case is 12 volts, and I'm going to connect it to the wall socket. So the board now is energized, so we're going to test it next. So now I'm in my print run directory. I'm going to open up Pronerface. Inside Pronerface, I'm actually going to connect to the printer. And as you can see now, it says connecting and printer is now online. So in order to test the motors, what we need to do is actually move them. So I'm going to actually move it 10 millimeters for the X axis, and we'll see what happens with the fan. So as you can see, the fan is now in motion. And that would normally be cooling our steppers. Now to test to see that it goes off, we're going to do motors off, which is usually a G code at the end of your print, and see what happens after 5 seconds. So after about 5 seconds, the actual fan terminated cooling. So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe, and thank you for your time.